We're going to be setting up this Gazelle Gazebo. It's new for 2021. We have the Gazelle G8 right over there. This is our first time setting up the gazebo.
He's going to do it by himself.
Let's see how it goes. Alright, so we're back. Going to set this up. Again, it's our first time here.
See if he can do it by himself.
That leads us to the sky.
Went on the inside, huh?
Well, it just happened to be that way.
On the tent we pull from the outside, but whatever works. We don't actually even know quite how big it's gonna be on our, this is an RV rug underneath here. We're not sure if it's gonna be the right size. We just had it. So I think this is the deluxe. It has the window panels or side panels on all of them, which also allows for the windows
right. That
can be zipped on and off. We decided that we would probably want ventilation in the panels in case it's sunny. It's pretty quick.
All right, so these poles come with it and they're for the doors. And there's a sleeve in the top. And it's leaving the bottom here. It just makes it a little bit more rigid. Let's see.
And then this part that we haven't done anything with at the front can be an awning, or it can be rolled up to the top.
So, I'm going to finish this other one here, right in the sleeve.
We were in the sky.
Right in the sleeve. So then above the door, there's another one of these. There's two pockets up in the corners, kind of in the roof. Might be too dark for you to see, but it's up here in this corner here, and you slide here. And there's another one right over here that you go put it in.
So basically, all the poles, or three of them, go around the opening.
Here. So this is what's going to keep your door frame
okay.
Open and sturdy.
I can't wait to see that one.
Alright, then we're gonna try to set up this awning here. We'll see, the ends aren't
okay, do it now.
Neither end is sharp, so kind of curious if this is just supposed to stay up like a static. So you're going to put it just like this, and there's some ropes in there that you tie off from the top and you pull straight. And that tension is what's going to hold your awning up. So we don't really have room to do that here. So we probably won't be setting it up for this job. unless we were to turn this thing around.
Well, we'll probably just roll it up. You can also roll up this front mm-hmm. and just have it up, which it's almost bedtime now. So in the morning, we probably just won't use the awning. We'll just roll it up underneath, you know, over the top so that we can go in and out.
All right, so it's the next day, the next morning. Beautiful morning right here on the water. We got here late last night and set up the tents pretty late, which is nice with the gazelles because they pop up really fast. We include this G6, I think it's called the G6 Deluxe Gazebo. So we got it all set up. Come on inside, take a look. It's kind of nice. We're using it as a little play area for the kids. We're using it as our cooking area. So last night, when I was setting up this door, it got kind of dark on this. And what I was showing you is there's these little pockets here for the top bar, and then here, and at the bottom for the side door. We'll get to that in just a second, buddy. Right behind you, this kept us warm last night in our tent. So there's plenty of YouTube videos on this thing. That's where we got it from, the YouTube videos. But basically, it's a little buddy heater. And it's the 4,000, 9,000 BTU. We put that little fan on the top, just like you'll see tons of YouTube videos, basically.
It's an aftermarket, right?
Yeah, so basically, we just kind of cut right there. I don't know if you can see that. And that allows it to sit right on top and in that top grate. And as the heat rises, it starts turning the fan, and so the fan blows out hot air throughout the tent. And you can see we got a buddy heater hose, and it's going out to the back of a 20-pound propane tank. The really nice thing about this gazebo are these windows here. It's kind of cool this morning. You see we're all wearing kind of hoodies and stuff, but we're able just to open up some windows, which is really nice. We looked at a clamshell, I think it was, and the reason why we chose this was couple things we liked. One was the windows for ventilation, and then two was it has the wind and rain barriers already on it, and you just zip it down and then they can fold up and it can all be mesh. So it's really, really nice.
And we didn't plan this when we bought it. We thought getting the outside panels would be great in case it was raining or something and we can zip it all up. But this morning when it was cold, we said, hey, let's just move the heater into right. The gazebo.
We cooked our breakfast in there, the kids played, and it was really toasty.
It was really
take some clothes off.
It was really, really warm, which was nice because sometimes you don't have anywhere to go and when it's so cold.
For reference, you'll see our tent set up. It was 26 degrees last night, and so we'll show you kind of how we stayed warm, and it worked out really well. Even our two kids, they were nice and toasty. So let's head over to the tent. We'll show you that. So this is the Gazelle T8. We love this thing. It's worked out really well so far for us. So come on in.
We had another video where we had queen size air mattresses. We have since changed that up a bit to give us a little bit more room.
Yeah, so this is our new sleeping arrangements. What we did was we bought these Trekology self-inflating air mattresses, and they're insulated as well. So this insulates from the ground, the cold air from the ground.
We don't know what the rating is, but it says all weather.
I think it's like an R5, but, or at least that's what other YouTube videos have said. I don't know for sure.
And you can buy them from the company or Amazon.
Yeah, Trekology.
For like $60 right now, you can get $20 off.
Was it?
$60 normally.
Yeah, I think we pay like $32 with $20 off, right?
Yeah.
So $52. So, yeah, so my son sleeps in this little mummy sleeping bag. And then we just took this wool blanket that I have and just kind of wrapped him in that. And he was really nice and toasty. For the adults, we are sleeping on a $32 Coleman cot with the self-inflating air mattress, the same Trekology, and just a sleeping bag. And nice and toasty. This is my daughter set up right here. So she slept right here, and then we had another blanket on top of her. And then my wife, the voice behind the camera, sleeps right here. And so...
And we decided on cots for the adults for several reasons. We're a lot heavier.
One, and it gives us chairs so the kids can sit down in the mornings and help get them dressed and things, so it's really nice.
And the storage underneath.
And yeah, we could throw stuff underneath. The reason we didn't go with cots for the kids, one, to save weight, but two... our kids are young. They're 3 and 6.
It's only like 40 pounds. So
yeah, and they're real light. So it's perfect for them. But also, for my three-year-old, we didn't want him rolling off the cot. So that was kind of nice. And then for the heat, what we did was, the nice thing is for these T8s, they have a front door and a back door. And so just like you saw over there, we just ran that propane tank. We left it outside. We put the heater right here with that fan blowing. And 26 degrees last night, and we were pretty toasty. We kept the heater on low probably till, I don't know, 3 o'clock in the morning. And we kicked it up to high, but we were toasty the whole night. So,
because that's one of my main complaints about camping is I hate being cold. Yeah. And I will say, last night, air mattresses deflated on us. We got over the air mattress pretty quick, although that's what we've always done. But I would say last night with this Trekology mat, the cot, sleeping bag, and heater, first time I have not been uncomfortable camping when it's cold.
In fact, like I said, 26 degrees last night. About 1 o'clock, we got woken up because we have neighbors next to us that was packing up and heading out. They were miserable and they were done with it. But I'll tell you, buddy heater, the small one, you don't need the big one. I think that'd be too much for a tent of this size anyways. An insulated pad underneath you, a good sleeping bag, and you'll be good. Something to keep that cold air off the ground. So, but this is our little campsite. So the other thing we got was, hey buddy, the other thing we got was these are pretty cool. So in the T8, they allow you to have different storage and, so we got this little light, $20 off of YouTube. It's
Amazon?
A light, or sorry, yeah, I said YouTube. It's a light and a fan all in one. And so it's pretty pretty handy. Gives you a little light in the dark to kind of see what you're doing, and then a fan as well. So if you want to kind of blow that hot air down from the heater, you can use it for that. Or during the summer months, kind of give us a little fan, and we just tuck it up in there, strap it in, and it works perfectly.
And there's a way to hang it. There's a hook also,
right? There's a hook as well, a little handle.
Which is what you see our little lantern.
Yeah, we have a little lantern
on the hook over here.
But this is it.
This is just an FYI. Don't put your jackets in the little pockets on the side, because ours were damp this morning.
Yeah.
But otherwise, it was a good night.
It's a good night. One more night to go, and then we're going to pack up and head out. So, my name's Ashley. Amber's behind the camper, or the camera. And that's
Tyler.
This is my little man, Tyler. So, y'all have a great day and happy camping. Bye.